You can choose the shape, you can choose the leather, you can choose the model, you can choose the kind of stitching, the color of the stitch, everything. It's not easy. Yeah. It's important to go inside of the mind of the customer. Mm-hmm. I have two goals. One is okay, comfortable, because the customer come here and for to have shoes comfortable, absolutely. But another goal for me, very very important, is to find the style, is to find to have a nice look.
Mr. Ugolini, thank you so much for taking Agnes Select interview. It's a great honor for me. So first, could you introduce yourself? What do you do?
Okay. I am Roberto Ugolini, shoemaker in Florence. I opened my company in 1995, about 27 years ago. Mm-hmm. And my first shop is shoes repair. Mm-hmm. For 2 years about.
For two
because,
years.
Yeah, only for 2 years. Because mm-hmm. I meet one shoemaker mm-hmm. just after some 1 year about from my open shop, and he taught me the shoemaker work. This is my teacher.
I see.
And for 1 year, I work inside of his shop for to study the shoemaker. I usually calculate from 1997, because for 2 years I make only the repair shoes.
But you learn all the crafts from that teacher?
Yeah.
Do you know who is his?
The name?
Yeah.
The name is Primo.
Primo.
Primo Vesilli. Now he's dead.
I see.
Without him, probably can make. Now I'm not here and make another work. I don't know what, but no shoes repair, because like it, but not too much. But it's completely different to make one new shoes and to repair.
I see. For
completely
sure.
Different.
For sure. And
also for the emotion. He is a great grandfather.
Yes.
And he grandfather.
So your great-grandfather is a shoemaker?
Also,
also your grandfather?
Yes. My father repairs shoes.
Oh, yeah.
My mother have a, not now, not closed, but yeah. Shop, shoe shop.
Selling
ready-to-wear.
Ready-to-wear?
Yeah, in out of town. Not nice quality.
You know, like
cheaper.
But you grew up in this like shoemaking environment, like the cultural. Well,
I took something from repair shoe from my father.
Yeah.
My master is Primo. And
yeah.
Primo is people out of family. Honestly, Primo is my first teacher. Uh-huh. He gave me the base to start. Mm-hmm. Okay. But in the year, I meet many shoemaker, old shoemaker, Florentine shoemaker. Mm-hmm. And from every shoemaker, I take something. I take some, because every time I ask today if it's possible to see the work. And some shoemaker have work also inside of my shop, just for, because like a hobby, because they are old, without money, just for to stay in my workshop, and I have many guys around.
I remember.
Okay, and for they is like a joke, like but for me it's important, because during the work, every time see the work of day for to take something, because the first thing is important to look.
Yeah.
This is the. the first, after the hand. But the first is a look. If you look, if you see well, and you remember the what you see before, you can work well also by hand. The mind, remember?
Yes.
I know many shoemaker, and I'm lucky because now in Florence there are old shoemaker, probably there are one or two, but they don't have a shop, they work inside of home, but it's not, but for the new young, the new generation, probably they don't have this opportunity.
No. It's hard.
I'm lucky.
Yes.
Very lucky.
Nice. So, your first trunk show to Tokyo is back in early 2000?
My first trunk show is 2011.
2011. That's to Tokyo.
Tokyo, Osaka, Kumamoto in the same time.
Yeah.
Three places. Mm-hmm. Yes.
And from that point, you gradually grow your Japanese clientele.
Yeah.
Right.
Yeah.
Today, are Japanese or the Americans your main clientele?
No, half and half at this moment. Honestly, mm-hmm. after the pandemic, more American mm-hmm. customer come back in Italy, mm-hmm. come back in Florence.
Mm-hmm. How your Japanese customers different from your American customers? The taste?
Absolutely different. Opposite. No. The Japanese customer is more. They are much attention to the details,
yes.
And they have idea of the fit, mm-hmm. the different of the American customer. American customer, that the shoes is important, comfortable immediately. The Japanese, but my philosophy is the shoes by to measure. It's not good if it's comfortable, but it's better when it's a little bit time, little bit, okay? Because slowly, the foot find the space inside. Slowly, just 4 or 5 times. For the American customer, this, not that they understand, but they prefer the shoes comfortable immediately. They put inside the foot, okay, go, now we can work. Japanese customer, I know my philosophy, and not also my philosophy, but the philosophy of from the shoemaker, is better if the shoes is comfortable in a few times, when you use it 4, 5, 6 times. Also, the Japanese customer, they know very well with the material. Some Japanese customer have also the experience, many experience from shoemaker, because now in Japan there are many shoemaker. And when they order the shoes to me, they have the clear idea what's about the kind of leather, the details of construction, and blah blah blah.
So, could you introduce to us what is the Ugolini taste? What's the Ugolini taste? What makes a shoe Ugolini?
A model.
Yeah.
But I think in you know, but for me this is Ugolini. Mm-hmm. Now in this moment.
Yeah.
Many customers have ordered the resume. Just but from 1 year. We have many orders to the resume.
Yeah.
Because this is easy, mm-hmm. easy, and also the look is nice. And the customer when try the first, I'm very happy.
Yeah.
Because I'm comfortable here with elastic. It's possible to have many chance for the instep. It's a height the elastic open when the instep is okay. Mm-hmm. The look is. Like this, but I love this model. I have personally 2-3 pair, probably more. Mm. I don't know why, honestly, but for me, Roberto Ugolini is this. Many people, many customers love this model, and they say, okay, this is Roberto. In this shape or in squared, it's okay. Like this one.
Yes, this is a beautiful piece. And I noticed that, so when you make the shoes, actually, yeah. You design the last as well. So yesterday when we were talking, you said some of our customers actually have a quite wide and fat feet. So in this circumstance, you still want to give it a shape, like to make it look maybe longer, to create more curves around the body. Could you explain that?
When I make the shoes for customer, especially for new customer, in this case I must to do the last. My first goal is the shoes comfortable. Okay, this is my first thing. But immediately is the look. I have two goals. One is okay, comfortable, because the customer come here and for to have shoes comfortable, absolutely. But another goal for me, very very important, is to find the style, to have a nice look, a nice style. Yeah. Because sometimes some shoemaker, but because I see something, they think it's important, comfortable, but the rest is not important. For me, it's very, very important both comfortable and style. It's sometimes, like yesterday, for example, it's not easy because the food is very particular. Yeah. But okay, I think it's possible, but it's possible. It's important to understand where I can change the shape, the last, and to make a little longer, or in some time make a little bit point, but it's possible.
Yeah,
it's possible, and this is for me it's very very important. Mm-hmm.
And I noticed that one thing you are very different from many maybe Japanese shoemakers is you have so many models, maybe because of your experience that you've been making shoes for so long, but also you are feels like you're willing to try different designs, different leathers.
But because this one is inside of me.
Yeah.
Not always have time, because I must produce the shoes for the customer, but when I have time, my passion is to make a new model and to find a new kind of leather, for to make some tests. Because this is my passion. Because I know here we have many, many models. But for me, I like to find a new model to make the cycle by from the old book, and just for me, I'm honestly just for me. This is my first book. For me, it's the more important book for my, because I take many ideas from here. Many. There are here, for example. And woods. And there are also a gilly. Here more and more.
Yeah.
Monk strap. Derby. Derby. Oxford.
Yeah.
This one for model ideas is more important of this. There are my two favorite books. Yeah. I have more, but I don't know, probably back.
Yeah.
I like it, I love it, because it's more, when I make, it's more emotional. It's not, because black is okay, brown is okay, but when I make one shoes like this, also for me, for my
I'm more satisfied.
But here we have probably a 50 model, 50, 5, 0. I think not many shoemakers have many models like me.
Indeed. And when the new customers come to you, how did you communicate the style? Like, if they don't know what they want, of course, if they know, it's easy.
No, it's not easy. Mm-hmm. It's important to go inside of the mind of the customer. Mm-hmm. When the customer don't have idea, clear idea about of the model,
yes,
or the style, we speak about something. I try to understand or to go inside of the mind of the customer, because this is very important for to have a communication.
What kind of questions you would ask them?
Now, the first question
is,
you want formal shoes or informal shoes? What do you do? Mm. What do you use? For what? For everyday with jeans and khaki pants or with suits? This is the first step. When the customer tell me, okay, formal, Oxford, you start, Oxford. It's the best. We have many kind of Oxford. The classic Oxford, cap toe or wingtip, the wool cut, Adelaide, Balmoral, we have many. Another question is, you like the dark color or light also color? Because some customer want only dark brown or black. If they tell me dark brown, dark color, it's okay. The chance are very smaller. Black or dark brown or gray. I prefer when the customer give me they tell me okay. They want my suggestion and I can give my idea and I can tell. My solution for to also I love, for example, to combination leather and color, but not always easy, because when the people don't have in front the shoes ready, many times they don't know.
I see.
The final
product.
It's very difficult. Also, when you go to the tailor, you have just one piece of fabric like this. You must image one suit. It's difficult.
Yes.
It's difficult. If especially when the customer is the first experience.
Yes.
After some years or after many pairs, okay, it's more easy for all customers. But the first time it is not easy.
So, what's the charm of bespoke shoes?
Because with the bespoke, you can have your personal product, your personal shoes. Because with the bespoke, the customer, the people can choose all shape, model, leather, construction, accessory, if they have initial. And the people, when they come inside, many people don't have idea of the solution, the chance. Because some customer, when I come in the shop for the first time, I explain them all. You can choose the shape, you can choose the leather, you can choose the model, you can choose the kind of stitching, the color of the stitching, everything. Some customer tell me, oh wow, really?
What's your standard to a beautiful shoe? What's your definition?
The beautiful shoes is when you think you talk about the model or
Everything. No. Maybe the shape of the last, the model, the leather. What makes a shoe beautiful? Like the most important.
No, the most important for me is the style.
Yeah.
To have a good style, respect of the body of the customer. Okay. And but don't have a. I repeat, my first goal is to find the comfortable, the measure, and after the style. But we have many experience for to make many kind of shoes for a different body of the people, because it's important. If you have a customer very high, but the foot is short, it's important to make more longer. Also, if in front they have the space, some customers they have, but in front now I have 2-3 centimeters of only space. It's okay because if I make your real foot, your real measure,
the proportion is
the look is terrible for you. And this is the people that go, wow, it's very, yes. When they take the new shoes, the final shoes, they are happy.